Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about how to use artboards in Photoshop CC 2019. So most Photoshop documents don't start out with artboards, so I'll show you how to make an artboard document. We'll also go over to how to add new artboards, and we'll go over why they're useful. So let's get started. Okay, I've got this web page set up, and right now we don't have any artboards at all. So I want to make an interior page, and really the best way to do this is to have artboards because we'll be using some of the elements on the interior pages, and that'll make it really easy to duplicate those. So I'm going to go up to Layer, New, Artboard. It'll just automatically make it the same width and height as your document, and that's what I want, so I'm going to say OK. You can see that it put all of these folders into another type of folder called Artboard 1. So when we go up here, we can see that all of this is on an artboard. If we want to create new artboards, all we have to do is click on the word artboard, and we get these pluses on every side. So we can add one to the right by clicking this, and then we can add more however we want. Now the nice thing about this is you can see all the pages. If you're doing user experience design, you'll be able to see all of your screens at once. So if you had like iPhone screens, you could have a whole bunch in one document. It makes it really easy. Now, the really cool thing about artboards is you can select some pieces that will be repeated across all of them all at once. So I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to click on my header and just Option and Shift drag this over here. And sometimes it'll go outside the artboard, so you won't be able to see it. So I'm just going to pull this right down onto that artboard. And there it is. I'll delete this other copy. So we'll get on this header and we'll pull it all the way up. I'll command click to select the logo, and I'll just double click on the vector smart object. We'll just make it into a square instead, and I'll save it. Then we'll go back to the Photoshop file, and you see it's updated here on artboard 2, but if you come over here, you can see that it's updated in both places. So if you duplicate one piece of it, it will always duplicate across all the artboards if you make a change, which is really, really nice. Now let's come down here to the footer. I want to show you another way of doing this. So we've got our footer here. I'm just going to hide it. Yep. Now I'm going to pull this over into our libraries. Now we'll get over on this one and I'll drag this from the library onto my artboard. Hit return. And now you can see that's down there. And you'll have the same ability here to update any part of this, and it'll update across all of your artboards equally. If we wanted to make this interior page a little shorter, we can do that. I'll just move this piece up, click on the artboard title again, and then you can drag a handle up. So now we have a shorter interior page, and of course you'd want to put a header here and then the text inside. Now another thing to remember about libraries, they can be used across any document. Now if we started a new document in Photoshop and we grabbed this out of our libraries, and we made changes in that new document, it would also update everything in this document as well, because libraries go across all software programs that Adobe offers. So that's a really nice thing about libraries, but you have to remember it. Just know that you're going to be changing it in every place where it's located. All right, now another nice feature that Photoshop has is that you can export all of your artboards at once. So I'll just go to File, Export, and then we can go Artboards to Files. Here we can choose where to put them and what they'll be called. And you can also choose the file type. I'm just going to do JPEGs and we'll run it. And this is actually an action. And also note when you do this, you need to have both artboards selected that you want to export. So go ahead and select them both, then go to File, Export, Artboards to Files. It'll take a moment to crop everything and get it ready for the export. And here are the exported files. Now you'll note down here that it didn't update this logo, and that's because it's a different vector smart object. So it is not tied to this because it has white text. This one has dark text. So they're not the same smart object, two separate ones. So you'd have to update it both places here. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week for another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.